Oh, 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 oh. Welcome back to the Omni Adventures YouTube channel. Today is another very special day because we're going back to City Walk. So today, this is my only adventure partner. Are you excited to be here?
Yeah,
so Marlene's at work currently, mm-hmm. but we're gonna have a hell of a time here at Universal City Walk.
Yeah!
So we're actually here on a Saturday.
Yeah!
But as you can see, this is about the busiest I've ever seen this line. So here's a look at the NBC Sports Grill. As you can see, they look basically ready to rock and roll. I can already see a few empty bottles over there. Got some humongous TVs that I would love to have in my apartment. Can't wait to try the NBC Sports Grill. So like I said earlier, you can definitely see that this is, for a fact, the most crowded I have ever seen City Walk post-Rona. Still, it is not horrible. I've seen much worse at Costco. I honestly feel that. Although there are a lot of people here, it's still not too hard to keep your distance. They've added more seating all around, which is a good sign. Ooh, could that barrier indicate that the stock market's getting ready to open up? Clarissa, do you like the stock market?
I've never been there, so I don't know.
Well, that's my favorite place, so.
Maybe when it opens, we can go see how it turns.
Oh, when it opens, we'll be there. Guaranteed. Looks like Ben and Jerry's has finally opened back up. Every time I come, they seem to be closed. Oh, Vivo's Kitchen is now serving pizza, but I heard that they are not currently serving pasta, which is a little odd to me. I seldom go to an Italian place expecting there to not be pasta. So it'll probably be a surprise for anyone who goes there expecting to have a plate of pasta. There seems to be a line of people. I believe it's for the studio store. I'm not entirely sure though. Interesting. I would have actually assumed that it was for Billabong. Maybe those people are just resting, but I could have sworn I saw a couple of them exit the line. Oh look, they're moving over. Yeah, I swear they're heading over into the studio store. So that's interesting. I've never seen a queue for it. Wow, there is a plethora of people. Funny story. You see that Waterworld area? That gate? Well, as you can see, we can't get there anymore. You used to be able to walk all the way over there and then all the way right where the restrooms were. And funny story, we actually came here numerous times filming City Walk and Halloween Horror Nights updates, RIP HHN. Oh, 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 oh. But anyways, so we actually would come and I would use a monopod, aka a selfie stick, to go over the fence and look through. And then we noticed that a lot of other people started doing the same thing. And one time we came here and I was heading in that general direction and a cast member or team member, I don't know what they're known as here, but he stopped me and he said, "Listen, bro, that was you, huh?" And I was like, "What?" He's like, "It was you. You're the reason we had to gate this up, because people started filming here. And I've seen you a lot of times doing that. And everybody else did it after you." And I was like, "Really?" He was like, "Yeah." So I guess we started a trend of people trying to find out more information regarding Halloween Horror Nights. So that's pretty cool. Oh, wow. Look how beautiful that golden sunset is. Ooh, even more beautiful is this little 8-year-old dancing. Ooh, 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 hey, hey. I wonder what they're doing over there. Huh. It's always good to come back and see that statue with Mr. Minion waving at us. Hi, Mr. Minion. Clarissa, when Universal Studios opens back up, what's the first ride you want to get on?
Park, I think.
Oh, it's Jurassic World now.
Oh, then Jurassic World and The Simpsons ride.
You like The Simpsons ride?
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of controversial because a lot of people don't like the shakiness of it.
I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah, I like it because you're not actually on a roller coaster.
Oh, you don't like roller coasters?
I do love them. Especially the one, the red one in Las Vegas.
Red one Las Vegas. Oh, at the Adventure Dome.
Yeah.
Ah.
And it just feels like you're actually on a roller coaster, but you're not.
Fair enough. We're now gonna take a trip into the studio store. And apparently they shifted the queue for just a second, but now it's back to where we thought it would be. Are you excited?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Into the store we go, and we have to be sanitary. As
yeah,
an 8-year-old can do it, so can you.
We have extra masks and some hand sanitizer.
Always got the hand sanitizers.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's explore
always
this
need
little
a
store.
Habit and always wear a mask.
Damn straight. Clarissa came straight here. Headband, yes. $15. Bow, $4. Button, $3. Ooh. That's an expensive headpiece.
I know.
Not quite as much as Disneyland, though. What is this, a crossover episode?
Okay, so I found the Secret Life of Pets section. There's a shark Hello Kitty here for some reason, but moving on. I love this shirt. It's so cute. And I also like this shirt because it's pink. And also, it has one of my favorite characters' face on it. And here's the plushie.
Did you know that the reason they're doing this merchandise is because they have a ride coming soon?
They do?
Uh-huh. Mm. It was supposed to open like literally a week before the Rona shut it down. It's called Secret Pets, or Secret Life of Pets.
Well,
Unleashed,
when,
off the leash, something like
well,
that.
Well, when Universal Studios opens back up, we're
whenever
definitely,
that is.
Yeah, whenever that is, hopefully very soon. We can go, but whenever it does open up, that's probably going to be the first ride we're going on, and maybe if you can, go on it too.
Oh yeah. Free wand with $175 plus purchase. I really have no idea if that's a good thing or not.
Oh, I just realized the bunny plushie's over there with the cat.
Yep. Oh, look at this.
Ooh, look down mouthful. Here.
Oh, they have a whole setup.
And then you can see from the light.
So much for a Christmas nativity. This is what I'm gonna have this year.
Oh god.
I'm sorry, what did you just say?
This is a Blackpink and Lady Gaga song that I love because I love Blackpink and BTS.
Huh?
I
okay.
like K-pop, okay.
okay? Okay. You grew up with me listening to metal. How do you go from Judas Priest and Metallica to BTS and Blackpink?
I really don't
We know. Listen to Black Sabbath and now you listen to Blackpink?
I know.
Bro, you have changed. So it's interesting. It seems like the longest line by far is for Hot Topic. You would think Hot Topic, which is readily available at basically any mall. Granted, many malls are closed, but I think a majority of them, especially like outlets, have Hot Topics operating. But their lines are crazy.
Okay, so my question is, why can't they play more Blackpink songs?
Okay, then we're gonna end this here. This is it.
Or at least
the interview's over. So an employee was telling us to come in earlier to the brand new production central, and it seems like there's basically no one inside, so we'll take his offer.
Yeah.
So Marlene absolutely loves E.T. Did you know that?
Yes, I did. That's
okay.
why she...
So I'm going to be getting her an E.T. What do you think we should get? A shirt or a sweatshirt? Which one do you think looks cooler? Personally, I think the shirt looks better.
Yeah, because it's actually colored.
All right. You know what? Let's do her a quick flavor. Is that $320 for a Dracula medallion? One-to-one exact replica? From the 1931 featuring Bela Lugosi.
Ooh.
Yeah, I'm definitely interested. 320. You guys bring it down another 100 and then we'll talk.
Look.
Yeah, the creatures from the Black Lagoon. What'd you say?
The monster has very big lips.
Yeah.
They plump.
What about it?
I don't know.
He's a monster. He eats people.
Okay, bye. Bye.
So one of Clarissa's favorite movies, oddly enough, Jaws. So take us to the merchandise, Clarissa.
Okay, so we have these cups and the little Jaws. These shirts. Painted. Another. And along this side, we actually have these
Funko Pops.
Yeah. We have these from Jaws. They're different characters. And then we have mugs and then another shirt. And over here, you must have saw it, but I think that's a fanny pack, I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure that these two are hats, but I don't know. So, yeah.
Quit acting like you're a princess. Get out of here.
I see the dress part section. So.
Look at this stuff. Look at that hat. Look at that lame hat. Who in the world would wear a hat like that? Right?
Okay, so we found this stuff. I'm not really sure what the name of it is, even though we're like. So they in big black words right there.
Well, that says Bates Motel, but it's from a film called Psycho by Alfred Hitchcock.
Mm-hmm.
They have Bumblebee and Optimus Prime costumes that are absolutely adorable. How much are they? Oh, they don't have prices that I can
find. And my mom.
Get out of here! I'm talking about the costumes. She's my sister. I can be mean to her. I don't see any price on the costumes. Once again, we had to come and say our prayers to Michelle Rodriguez, because as any fan of Universal Studios knows, Michelle Rodriguez is a goddess, apparently. So besides getting that gift from my lovely lady, Marlene, I think we're gonna pick up one of these guys for the studio. Oh yeah. I didn't notice this last time, but they have a bunch of posters. They have Jurassic World, Jaws, I have that one. Hollywood, I live there. Simpsons, Back to the Future, Marilyn Monroe. Is that Lucy? E.T., Scarface. Ooh, I'm down with some Scarface. That looks like old school Hollywood. Ghostbusters, The Walking Dead. I only liked like 17 episodes of The Walking Dead. Oh, I'll have you, Boris Karloff. The OG Jurassic Park. Which one do I get? Taking you back right now. Come on, get your butt over there. Get your butt over there.
We just got a huge update regarding Halloween Horror Nights merch coming to Universal Studios City Walk here in Hollywood. But before that,
oh, you're a nectar.
Yeah, and I'm super excited because I haven't been here in a long time. And I've only been to here once before with my best friend Karina. So yeah.
So we made it out of Nectar, and
yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, I had never been there before and I had no idea what they sell. But and
they had this thing where there was sugar and then other stuff in it. They had different scents and then it made your hands so soft.
Yes, very soft. Convincingly soft that I spent way too much money for my first time going to Nectar.
I got her some bath bombs because we have a jacuzzi tub at home and
yeah,
she's been waiting for
them. Yeah, they gave us a free one too.
Yep.
So yeah, we'll see you at the outro.
So
here is our haul from Nectar.
Yep. Manny has this lotion. Is it for Marla?
No, it's for me.
For Manny. And then, is this for Manny?
What?
Is this for Manny?
This for me too, are you kidding me? All this for me, check this out. These are bath bombs.
Yep, I got lavender. We actually got four bath bombs. And Manny obviously had to get one for himself.
I didn't get a bath bomb.
I
got stuff
for
me though.
If you want a bath bomb, you can have one.
These sugar scrubs.
This is a salt scrub.
Salt scrub. No, she said sugar, bro.
Look.
Oh,
right there is
salt.
A salt scrub.
She said there was a sugar one. It was this one, yeah.
Yeah. Because there are sugar ones and salt ones. And then this is the free one that we got.
Yep. On top of that, we also got this Jurassic Park poster, which will go in the studio.
And we got some of these spoons.
To make it easy. Uh-huh. And here is that shirt we got from my lovely, beautiful girlfriend. Uh-huh. We'll show her reaction right here. Hello, Marlene.
Hello.
Welcome back from work, my lovely girlfriend.
Thank you.
We have a surprise for you.
A surprise? No way. Ah! It's an E.T. shirt. Thank you. Oh my God, I love this thing. Oh my God, thank you. You got a kiss off camera.
I told you she'd like it.
Oh my God, I love it. Thank you.
Didn't that just warm your heart? I love that chick so much. My God. And that wraps up our day here at City Walk. Did you have fun?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. So please do us a huge favor. Go ahead and like this video and subscribe with those bell notifications turned on. Follow us on social media at OADV_media. We'll see you next time here on the Omni Adventures YouTube channel. My name is Manny and we're out.
Bye.
So here is the news regarding the Halloween Horror Nights merch that could potentially be coming to Universal Studios Hollywood. Now, I say Universal Studios Hollywood because I was also given an update on the park's potential date by an actual employee in the Production Central store, that is. So when I asked originally, like, how's it going getting the park reopened, she at first started giving me a generic answer, like the one you can get from the social medias and everything. She's giving me the, we don't know, everything's tentative, yada yada. And I was like, all right, let me ask you a further question. How is it going with the state's regulations? And she said, we've actually already been given the regulations. The issue is we need the actual county's numbers to go down before we can officially pitch an idea. What she told me is that they've been pitching ideas almost like daily, it seems, and every single thing they have has been getting denied. The closest thing they had to an approval for the theme park is Production Central. Apparently that actually had to be regulated by the city as well. And everyone had been having a huge demand for in-park merchandise, which is the entire reason Production Central was even created. So Production Central, if you didn't know, is actually only a temporary pop-up. So what she said was that potentially they could only be around for 2 more weeks. 2 more weeks if things go well. That's what she told me, if things go well. What that means is if the park opens, Production Central's gone. That's what she told me, basically. She kind of hinted around it, and when I asked when the park opens, Production Central goes away. Sorry, I can't talk, I'm very excited. But yeah, she basically confirmed that when the park opens, Production Central closed down. And she said 2 weeks. Universal is basically just gonna open the moment they can, and I really don't think they're gonna be like announcing it. So that's very, very exciting. On top of that, what she said about the Halloween Horror Nights merchandise is that they don't even know if they're going to get it or not. They said everything goes to Orlando first, which is why Orlando already has it and we don't. And all the distributors and the people who are actually creating the merchandise, everything's been stupid backed up. All the ports are backed up. So they have no idea when they're going to get it. But they were supposed to roll it out last week. That's what she said. The intention was to roll it all out. But they can't. If Production Central remains open for a couple more weeks, they're going to actually update merchandise. But until then, until it's official that they're going to continue opening or not, everything's going to stay the same. So for the next couple of weeks, there's not going to be anything new in Production Central. But you will find more if they... Personally, I really don't think Universal is going to open in 2 weeks. So there'll definitely be a new rollout of merchandise in the next couple weeks. So excited for that, but I'd much rather be in the park, of course. With that all being said, I know this is a lot to take in, and I'm sorry I'm rambling on, but yes,
the moment you see Production Central start to close, we have confirmation that the park is about to open. That's pretty crazy to me. So regarding the merchandise again, she did say though, the caveat is if they manage to get the merchandise within like, I'd say a month, they'll probably roll it out. But if they can't get it in time, which would be like October or November, which is kind of odd because, you know, Halloween is in October, but I guess, I don't really know the timeline they're necessarily working with. But what she said is that they have the potential to grab the merchandise and not even sell it because it could be outdated already. And the business is thinking about just canceling merchandise for Halloween Horror Nights in Hollywood altogether if things keep going the way they are. So there's a lot to take in and it's pretty scary. But yeah, that's your update from an official inside source.